Hello and welcome back. Our last video showed how to get up and running with Ozone. Here I have loaded my previous project. Now we can explore some of the fancy stuff. The Ozone debugger has a slew of windows that provide valuable information to assist in debugging any ARM code or target on any platform, be it PC, Mac or Linux. The various windows can be selected from here. The console shows the commands that have successfully run and flags any command errors. Commands are invoked by the .jdebug file at the start of a debug session or by user actions during a session. It also shows more information like background jlink activity. The console also accepts command inputs. This command, for example, will halt the debugger. Just type ?? To get a list of commands. The terminal window supports semi-hosting, SWO output, and Zegra's real-time transfer, or RTT. You can see this here. Bidirectional communication is possible with the target device via the terminal window. Live watches support a configurable update rate of variables on a per symbol basis. To set a watch, select the variable and click right or shift W. Here I have a watch set for the OS global variable time. On a right click, the menu shows various options. This is where the update rate can be adjusted. The memory window supports configurable live updates while running and highlights of the change memory content. The change highlight color has three configurable levels, showing the most recent change in one color, the predecessor in another, and so on. The memory window toolbar allows write or dump of memory contents, as well as other options. Ozone source level debugging allows users to examine program execution both on a source code and machine code level. It supports inline disassembly in the source code and mix mode in disassembly. In addition, assembly level debugging is possible without the source code being available. Thanks for watching.